Hello, I'm Shobana and this is AVS.
Padmashree Shobana is a trained classical dancer. She's also a big film star, seen over the years in multiple award-winning movies in multiple languages. Well, that's all well and good, but last week she was live and in living color for a dance drama called Krishna. It's been getting rave reviews back home and is now on a nationwide tour of the United States. Our Jessica Thomas sat down with the actress at Bina Menon's dance studio in New Jersey.
Shobanaji, thank you so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about the show and what you have in store for your fans?
It's almost like a decade since I've come to America, and we are all very, very excited. So Krishna, the musical, is in English. So it's just not about, a particular kind of a religious story. He is an icon, but also for many other things. So we are just trying to showcase Indian artistry in terms of color, in terms of dance, classical dance, and of course there is a smattering of Bollywood dancing, because it's also very much now Indian. So though I'm trained in classical, I've also done so many Indian films, so it is very much a part of me. So I've just used everything and hopefully going to present a very bourgeois kind of a show.
I'm drunk with love for you.
Now you have some very big names associated with the show, like Konkana Sen Sharma, Shabana Azmi. How were you able to get them on board, and what role do they play in the show?
These are like wonderful artists. They are the names that you've said, which is Konkana Sen Sharma, Shabana Ji, and then we also have Radhika Ji, we have Surya, who's like, you know, one, the topmost South Indian film hero. So all of them just loved the script, and they wanted to lend their voices for the characters.
I have given you my all, Krishna. Leave me something in return. Krishna, I have faith that you will come.
That is rubbish. He can fight, he can eat, drink, he can make love.
Now I'm sure you and your dancers have gone through rigorous practice. How do you manage to stay so young, fit and beautiful?
Young, I don't know. Fit also, I don't know. Beautiful, you're joking. So thank you. But it is a practice, so also sometimes we get hurt, and that's all very much part of the game.
Now I want to shift gears a little bit and talk about your films. You took a break from cinema for a while and then came back in 2013 with Tira.
Right.
Why is that?
Just decided to do only a film that would interest me. So, and that was a little rare, because you know, as you go on in life, people think that you're older and they have only a particular kind of scripts to offer you, which didn't excite me. So this Tira was a film that, more than the film, it was the director who was very particular that he wanted me, and he was a very capable man, and he really motivated me immediately. So once he told me the script, and you know there is a surge of excitement that you get when you hear a particular script. So I think that was when I decided to do it, and I haven't like taken a break, a conscious break. It's just that I've been so busy doing other things.
Kalira, Dr. Kalira.
I want to talk a little bit about your film Mani Chittitaru, which was later made into 6 different languages. Tell me a little bit about that role for you.
Mani Chittitaru was done 2 decades ago. So it's great that we are actually talking about it even now, which shows the power of that film. And I believe they've taken it in the 6 different languages. I think it was a hit in all the 6. What I remember of it was a very unique experience because of the director. So he knew he was onto something big. So there was this whole excitement in the crew, because everybody knew that you know, the film is going to be a success. But the amount of success and the power the film was going to have for about two decades and maybe even more, we didn't know. But we were very excited while we were shooting for that film.
அப்ப நீ என்ன இங்கிருந்து எங்கேயும் போக விட மாட்டாய். உனக்கு எவ்வளவு தைரியம் இருந்தா இப்பவும் என் கண் முன்னாடி வந்து நிப்ப.
Now after the show, what's next for you?
After the show, I have to go home. My daughter has school, so it's probably about buying books and the whole hullabaloo about, you know, getting her to school and getting her out of jet lag.
Very excited. We've been wanting to do this for the last 3 years, ever since she started Krishna. So now finally she's here. I think this will be one of the best production that has been brought from India ever to America.